We think quantum mechanics is the fundamental theory of nature. Until we have a computer which can really, you know, simulate what is around us, it's kind of an incomplete computer in a sense, right? So let's build a quantum computer for that, which can truly simulate nature, right? So it's like a new paradigm for computing. It's not just about like making our current computers a little bit faster, right, or a little bit better, but it's about building a completely new kind of computer, a computer where the building blocks, they are not bits, but they are what we call qubits. They are like elementary quantum mechanical systems of like photon or for electron.
We're starting to build quantum computing machines that can emulate and simulate small quantum systems, but they're too noisy right now. And their error rates are sort of 1% to 0.1% every gate operation you might perform.
We can do like 200 or so operations before there is a failure. So that's an improvement, but if you think about a transistor, right, the classical counterparts of a qubit, there we can make like hundreds of billions of operations before error. And the reason for that is quantum mechanical systems, in a way, they are very fragile objects. So they interact with the environment, right, with other particles nearby them, with stray magnetic fields and all kinds of other systems, and they lose their quantum features very quickly.
You know, as we're doing a computation, how can we correct for these errors so that they don't build up, and in a way that we don't create new errors? It turns out that's a really hard thing to do with quantum systems, much different than in a classical system. We're looking around at all sorts of different material systems and physical systems to implement qubits and quantum computers.
But I really think that this very serious effort that we have right now in scale up these quantum systems, it will pay off. And in 10 years, way more qubits, right? Much better control of them.
We will be able to, you know, model and simulate different types of materials on a small scale in the beginning. But that will teach us more about quantum systems themselves, in particular how many particles interact and the different exotic types of materials that can emerge. I think over the next 5 years, you'll start to see a better optimization problems where you might have some constraints on a system, but it's got so many different variables in it that you want to know under those constraints, what's the optimal solution? It's not so much a specific application, but it gets at the heart of what's interesting about quantum information science and about quantum computers in general. It is a very different way of managing information and computing information than we do classically.
Once you get there, indeed, I'm sure there will be other applications. We never have built a system with billions of quantum particles strongly interacting with each other and completely isolated from the environment, right? So maybe there is new physics there that we don't understand, right? And it will be very exciting to see what happens.